Hello children, in today's class we will do word problems based on multiplication. First question is, a man saves rupees 350 per month. How much money does he save in 4 years? It is given to us that the saving of a man per month is rupees 350 and we have to find out his savings in 4 years. So firstly, we know that in 1 year there are 12 months. So, in 4 years, there will be 12 multiplied by 4 months. That is 48 months. Basically, we have to find out the savings of the men in 48 months. So money saved in 1 month is equals to rupees 350. So money saved in 48 months, in place of 4 years, we can also write 48 months. So in 48 months, it will be 350 multiplied by 48. So 350 and 48. Start the multiplication. 8 into 0, it will be 0. 8 fives are 40, so we will write 0 here. 4 will be carried. 8 threes are 24. 24 plus 4, 28. Now we will multiply with 4. So firstly put 0 as 4 is at tens place. So 0 will come here at ones place. 4 into 0, 0. 4 fives are 20, 2 carried here. 4 threes are 12, 12 plus 2, 14. Now we have to add both of these numbers. So after addition, 0 plus 0, 0. Here also 0. 8 plus 0, 8. 4 plus 2, 6 and 1. So, answer is money saved in 4 years is equals to rupees 16,800. Next question is, Sita types 68 words per minute. How many words does she type in 2 hours 20 minutes? So it is given to us that words typed in 1 minute is equals to 68. We have to find out that how many words did she type in 2 hours 20 minutes. So firstly, we have to convert this 2 hours 20 minute into minutes. We know 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. So 2 hours 20 minutes, it will be equals to 2 multiplied by 60 plus 20 minutes. 2 multiplied by 60 is 120 plus 20 minutes, which will be equals to 140 minutes. That means we have to find out the number of words typed by Sita in 140 minutes. So words typed in 1 minute is equals to 68. Words typed in 140 minutes, it will be equals to 68 multiplied by 140. So we have to do the multiplication of 68 and 140. 140 and 68. Multiply them. Here, firstly we have to multiply 140 by 8. So 8 into 0, 0. 8 fours are 32. 3 will be carried. 8 ones are 8 plus 3, 11. Now 0 will come at 1's place as 6 is given at 10's place. So firstly place 0 here and then start multiplying by 6. 6 into 0, 0. 6 fours are 24. 2 will be carried. 6 ones are 6 plus 2, 8. Now add them. 0 plus 0, 0. 2 plus 0, 2. 4, 1 plus 4, 5. And 8 plus 1, 9. So answer is words. Typed in 2 hours 20 minutes is equals to 9520. Next question is, a bag contains 24 kg 500 gram sugar. How much sugar do such 224 bags contain? So here, quantity of sugar in one bag is given to us. We have to find out quantity of sugar in 224 such bags. So, quantity of sugar in one bag is equals to 24 kg. 500 gram. Quantity of sugar in 224 bags, it will be equals to 24 kg 500 gram multiplied by 224. So write them in column, kg, gram, 24 kg and 500 gram multiplied by 224. So firstly we will multiply the number by 4. 4 into 0, 0. 4 into 0, 0. 4 5s are 20, so 0 will be written here and 2 carry to the next number. 4 4s are 16 plus 2, 18, 1 carry. 4 2s are 8 and 1, 9. Now, when we will multiply the number by 2, so we will put 1, 0 here at 1's place. Then 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 5, 10. 1 will be carried. 2 into 4, 8. 8 and 1, 9. 2 into 2, 4. Now, again multiply by 2. But this 2 is at 100's place. So, put 0 at 1's place and 10's place. Then, 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. 2 into 5, 10. 1 carry. 2 into 4, 8. 8 and 1, 9. And 2 into 2, 4. Now add them. You will get 0 plus 0 plus 0, 0. Here, 0, 0. Then 8 plus 0 plus 0, 8. 9 plus 9, 18. 1 carry. 9 plus 4 plus 1, 14. 1 carry. And 4 plus 1, 5. So here answer is quantity of sugar in 224 bags is equals to 5488 kg. As you can see, the last three digit here, the and the grams column, all are zero. That means 0 grams. So answer is 5488 kg. Next question is, using 346 multiplied by 4 is equals to 1384, find the following products. First is 346 multiplied by 40. In this question, we can see that if we multiply 346 by 4, so this product is already given to us, that is 1384. So we can write it as 346 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 1 zero is there, so we can write it as 10. 346 multiplied by 4 is 1384 multiplied by 10, which is equals to 13,840. Next part is 346 multiplied by 41. So here 41 is given to us. So we can write it as 346 multiplied by 40 plus 1. 41 can be written as 40 plus 1. Now what we have to do is, we have to multiply 346 by 40 and 346 by 1. And then we have to add both the products. So 346 multiplied by 40 plus 346 multiplied by 1. We already know the product of 346 multiplied by 40. It is 13,840 plus 346 into 1 is 346. After adding both the numbers, we will get 14,186. In the next part, it is given 346 multiplied by 39. So here we are having 39. Now we can write it as 346 multiplied by 40 minus 1, as 39 is equals to 40 minus 1. Now what we will do, we will multiply 346 by 40 and we will multiply 346 by 1. After that, we will find the difference between both the products. So 346 multiplied by 40 minus 346 multiplied by 1. So 346 into 40 is 13,840 minus 346. This will be equals to 13,494. Next question is, Ram has 520 currency notes of 20 rupee each. How much money does he have? So suppose if you have 5 notes of 10 rupee each, then the amount which you are having is rupees 10 multiplied by 5, that is 50. So if you have 5 notes of 10 rupee each, then money with you is 10 into 5, 50. In this question, Ram has 520 notes of 20 rupee each. That means the money he have is equals to 520 multiplied by 20. So number of rupees 20 notes is equals to 520. Therefore, money he have will be equals to rupees 20 multiplied by 520. Now you can see in this question, zeros are given at the last place. So we can multiply 2 by 52. And then in the product, we can write 2 zeros at the last. So 2 multiplied by 52 is equals to 104. Now 2 zeros are there, 1 in 20 and 1 in 520. So increase 2 zeros here. Therefore, answer is money he have is equals to rupees 10,400.